वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर खोडदे ऋषिकेश एंड यू आर वॉचिंग बीएससी बॉटनी स्टडीज क्लासेस। हियर वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग अवर डिस्कशन ऑन द टॉपिक नाइट्रोजन मेटाबॉलिज्म। सो फ्रेंड्स, ऑन द बोर्ड आई हैव रिटन द नाइट्रोजनेज एंजाइम स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन। सो दिस नाइट्रोजनेज एंजाइम इज वेरी यूनिक, विच हैव कैपेसिटी टू कन्वर्ट दिस एटमोस्फेरिक नाइट्रोजन इन टू the ammonia, we can say two ammonia. So the conversion process takes energy. In previous parts we have discussed how this enzyme do this job. Here we are discussing the structure of this enzyme, which is very important in not only the BSc study as well as for competitive exams. So first of all, it is very essential to know where this enzyme occurs. This enzyme occurs in both bacteria, symbiotic as well as non-symbiotic bacteria. Both bacteria shows presence of this enzyme. The symbiotic bacteria shows this enzyme presence in root nodule, where non-symbiotic bacteria shows the presence of enzyme in heterocyst. As well as there are some non-symbiotic bacteria who do not contain any heterocyst, where they have shown special temporal specification for nitrogen fixation. But nitrogenase enzyme is present in both these bacteria. This is, I want to clear to you that nitrogenase enzyme perform this role, but they occur in both types of bacteria. So now let's discuss about, first of all, what is an enzyme. After that we will discuss about nitrogenase enzyme. So everyone will say we know about enzyme. Yes, everyone know about an enzyme, but these enzymes generally are considered as made up of protein, and very few enzymes are reported where RNA work as an enzyme. We will not discuss about how these RNA works. There are very much examples about ribonuclease types of RNA enzyme where they perform the role. But we will not discuss about this RNA here. We will discuss about the protein based enzyme, the enzyme which composition is protein. So some enzyme shows only protein presence. In some enzyme you will find only protein is there, who is working, who is acting with their active site. This is active site where substrate bind. But there are some enzyme where helping partner, please listen carefully, helping partner in association with the protein is required for enzymatic activity. Why we are discussing this? We will get to know this importance of this topic. So this type of proteins based enzyme are known as holoenzyme. This type of enzyme are known as holoenzyme. The protein component is known as apoenzyme. Protein based component is known as apoenzyme. The helping partner are of two types. Either they may be organic or either they may be inorganic. The helping partner may be organic or inorganic. The helping partner, I will wipe out this. The helping partner, if organic, generally they are vitamin. Helping partner which are organic generally are vitamin, and inorganic partner which are inorganic generally are metal ions. If helping partner is organic, which is vitamin, then it is known as coenzyme. And if helping partner is inorganic, then it is known as cofactor. Please understand this. It is very essential. What I have written here, protein based enzymes are there, But sometimes protein require helping partner. The composition of helping partner and protein known as holoenzyme. The protein component is known as apoenzyme. The helping partner may be organic or inorganic. Helping partner if organic, it is generally vitamin. And helping partner if inorganic, it is generally metal ion. If organic helping partner is there, it is coenzyme. And if inorganic helping partner it is there, it is called as cofactor. Both the case, coenzyme or cofactor are helping partner. They are not called as a helping partner. It is very ordinary word. In biochemistry, they are called as prosthetic group. So in holoenzyme, you will have apoenzyme and prosthetic group presence. Nitrogenase enzyme is an example of holoenzyme. So why I have discussed this? The reason is that the nitrogenase enzyme is holoenzyme where it contains protein as well as one prosthetic group. The prosthetic group is generally metal ion. That's why nitrogenase enzyme is also known as metalloenzyme. Remember this word. So it was regarding about enzyme and introduction of nitrogenase enzyme. Now let's discuss about the structure of nitrogenase enzyme. So point I have highlighted here is structure of nitrogenase enzyme. First I will draw a prototype. On that basis we will discuss a detailed structure. So the prototype is generally drawn for understanding. Nitrogenase enzyme shows component 1 component 2. So there are two components in nitrogenase enzyme. Remember this, component 1 and component 2. I will write on the head of this component. Component 1 and component 2. Component 1 shows 4 proteins groups. One, two, three, four. Four subunits are present in component 1. That's why it is called as a tetramer. And in component 2, you will have only two components, component 1 and component 2. That's why it is known as dimer. So remember this, two components are there. Component 1 contain 4 subunits, component 2 contain 2 subunits. Each of the 4 components of subunits of component 1 shows presence of metal ion, molybdenum and iron. I will write here. Each of the 4 components in component 1 subunit shows molybdenum and Fe, and component 2 subunit shows presence of only iron. Now it is clear up to you. The metal ion is present with the protein association. That's why it is a holoenzyme in which protein as well as metal ions are present. So it is very essential to understand the structure of nitrogenase enzyme. First of all, you need to understand how reaction takes place in nitrogenase enzyme. The electron travels in this fashion. There is a electron carrier who takes electron, gives to the complex component 2. This component 2 transfers that electron in component 1, and this component 1 convert molecular nitrogen into ammonia. So it is just a prototype, don't worry, we will discuss each and everything in a detail. So friends, let's discuss about a detailed structure of nitrogenase enzyme. Detailed structure of nitrogenase enzyme, where you know that component 1 and component 2 are there. The component 1, I have drawn component 1 where we have said 4 subunits were present, where you will have to show four subunits are there. Okay, so one subunit is of alpha type, one subunit is of beta type, alpha and beta subunits are there, two alpha and two beta subunits are there. So already we have said that they contain MOFE as a metal ion present in there. The most peculiarly, you will find the presence of iron cluster between alpha and beta subunits. You will have to write this point, presence of Fe cluster. So there are two points here where you will find the Fe cluster is present. This Fe cluster is known as P cluster. So you will have to highlight in your answer sheet what is P cluster. Cluster means grouping. Grouping means which grouping? Iron grouping. Iron ions are there. Fe is in periodic table depicted for iron. So in complex one, you will have 4 subunits, 2 alpha, 2 beta. Between alpha and beta, you will have iron cluster. So 2 iron cluster are there. So it is called as a P cluster. Okay. So it was regarding the subunit or component 1 in which 4 subunits were there. And remaining is a component 2 where you will have similar size Fe subunit containing component. So component 1 and component 2 are somewhat different. Why it is so essential to talk about this? First, understand this first. I will wipe out these names. The component 2 is very special because it is actually the component who is involving the energy in the reaction, the ATP. How many ATPs? We have seen 16 ATPs are required, which converts into ADP and inorganic phosphate. 16 ADP will be there and 16 inorganic phosphate will be there. The bond is phosphoanhydride bond, which breaks and releases energy. That energy is utilized for nitrogen fixation. Here we are talking about the structure of nitrogenase enzyme, where component 2 contain 4 subunits and component 1 contain 2 subunits. 4 subunit component 1 contain molybdenum and iron, and say component 2 contain only iron. So very metal iron rich protein it is. That's why it is also called as metalloprotein or metalloenzyme. Okay. So component 2 contain iron, and who is actually involving the breakdown of ATP into ADP plus inorganic phosphate, which releases energy. So this component 2 contain iron, and also it shows the presence of cluster between these two subunits. This cluster is known as Fe4S4 cluster. So we have seen here the two clusters, different clusters. In component 1 we had P cluster, and component 2 we have Fe4S4 cluster. So it was regarding the structural analysis of nitrogenase enzyme. It will be very easy to remember and understand nitrogenase enzyme. Now let's discuss about the functional aspect of nitrogenase enzyme. So friends, I have written function of nitrogenase enzyme here. Now let's discuss about how nitrogenase enzyme perform the action. So first of all, we will draw subunit 2 or 2 subunits of component second and 4 subunits of component 1 where you have alpha, beta, alpha and beta. Okay, so let's discuss about how this reaction happens. First of all, pyridoxine. There are several electron carrier in our cell. For example, NADPH, NADP, FAD. This FAD is pyridoxine. This pyridoxine is when having electron is in reduced form. Whenever anything have electron, it is in reduced form always. So pyridoxine takes electron, gives electron to the component number second. Pyridoxine gives electron to the component number second. Here is an iron presence. Here is also an iron presence. Okay. Don't get confused. Iron is single iron present in component number second. Once giving the electron, this pyridoxine is converted into the oxidized state. Pyridoxine is converted into oxidized state. The component number second now having that electron. Electron are always in two or in pair. So these electrons are transported on the component number second. This component number second do not contain or do not maintain this electron. They donate this electron to the component one. So this electron will move to the component number 1 where you have MOFE. Here you have MOFE, which are metal ions. These electrons are transported to the component second to the component 1. Here also they shifted from one subunit to the another subunit with the help of metal ions, and finally the molecular nitrogen receives those electron and protons also required for the reaction, as already we have seen. So two ammonia get produced, and already we have said that for this reaction 16 ATP are required. So it was regarding the functional aspect of nitrogenase enzyme. Hope you have understood this lecture. We will meet in our next part, and please subscribe this channel, and thank you for your time. Bye.